G'day, my name is Dr. John Dombrowski. I'd like to talk to you today about neuromodulation or spinal cord stimulation. We do this for patients with generalized low back pain or patients with neck pain that have had surgery that didn't really turn out that well, or patients who perhaps do not want surgery. Now, obviously, as an anesthesiologist and someone that specializes in pain medicine, we don't change your anatomy. We try to come up with a way to change the way you feel about your anatomy to make you more functioning. Now, obviously, when people are watching these videos, they've tried everything. They've done surgery, they've been on medication management. Let's talk to you about what spinal cord stimulation is. Well, once you've been selected as the right particular type of patient, it's fairly straightforward. Here's a model of your low back or your lumbar spine. This is your tailbone that you sit on, or the sacrum. First off, the way it starts is by placing an epidural. Now, anesthesiologists do epidurals every day, such as in the OB suite. So this is done fairly straightforward, just like in an office-based setting like we are in today in a fluoroscopy suite. Once we determine that you're the right candidate, we then clean the area off with a significant amount of alcohol, other clean agents for the skin. We then anesthetize the skin with local anesthetic. Once the skin is anesthetized, we then place the needle in between the backbones and then identify the epidural space. Once the epidural space is identified, we then simply take this lead, or essentially a piece of spaghetti that has these little metal contacts on it. The metal contacts conduct electricity. The leads are introduced through the needle and up through the spinal space, it's called the epidural space, just like an epidural catheter for OB. Once the lead is placed, the lead comes outside the skin, and you go home with this for about a week to make sure you're a great candidate for this particular procedure. You go home the same day, it's done in an office-based setting. Rarely any anesthesia, such as IV sedation, is ever required for patients. And that's it. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.